sons, and they want to go to New York, because there it is happening. I said, have you been in New York? No, only once. Yeah, but how do you come to your vision of New York as a brand? He said, it's a great destination, we see it on television every day. A lot of fun, movies, that's the place where it happens. I said, yeah, but most of the movies are not shot in New York. They're shot off or in Chicago, yeah, or in California, yeah. But they create an image of the place of New York. That is maybe not the real New York. But anyway, those four films have made New York, and we can find maybe 10 more. So films and destination promotion are interlinked. Funny, the Amsterdam government has decided not to participate anymore in foreign films. Yeah, because it upset the people locally that the road is closed. Yeah, which I think is wrong. Yeah, but anyway, here we see the tension between the 16 million managing directors, yeah, who or 5 million who have an other opinion than the other one, yeah, who wants to do it. Sport events. I think Beijing did a tremendous good job. I mean, the opening ceremony of the Olympic Games was one big promotion of Beijing. And I've been at the Games. In the beginning, it was a little bit funny, you know, awkward. Yeah, you were being searched and etc. But I have had the best time in Beijing. Never a dull moment. I never felt scared. And they created, there was an article, they created about, they say, about $4 billion US dollars in publicity. Yeah, so that is added to the value of the name Beijing, which I think is good. On the cost side, on the other hand, yeah, I think the cost was way out of balance. The same with South Africa, football. Everybody was scared. Can they do it? Can they not do it? But they did it. I think the image of South Africa has been improved because they handled the games well. Only those horrible tutors they should take away. And SAIL Amsterdam, I think, is also a very good event. But events have a product life cycle. It could be it is at the top, yeah, and it goes back, goes down. So maybe we should come with a new event in the coming time. It's also an event that fits to Amsterdam. In my discussion with burgomasters and ministers, I've always said, you find an event that fits your city, and not that is awkward, doesn't belong there, because people feel that. And I'm not saying because Saxion is in Deventer, but I think the city of Deventer has made a number of events that exactly fit in the image of the city, which is okay. Yeah, this is something else. I tried when I was the minister of, when I did CEO of Tourism Board, to make a connection with the economic department. That Made in Holland was the same, used the same logo as we did, in vain. Yeah, because we were industry and tourism. Tourism? Yeah, is that industry? Yeah. So you have to bring those groups together. Yeah, and finally we achieve. But that's a big challenge. And I think, especially in the coming decades, when Made in France is becoming much more important than it was in the past, because what is left? Most of the things are made in China these days. So let's be proud that on those things that we still can make in our countries. And let those two connect together. So my theory is that without a proper brand management, this type of promotion will create only what I say a rumor in the market, but not a brand, because a brand is consistent. Like the Coca-Cola brand, you know what you buy, you know what you get Coca-Cola, and not something else. And sometimes I have said to ministers and burgomasters, they should go back to the hotel schools or to the tourism schools, and get a re-education before they start dictating what the policy should be in tourism. Yeah, it's very funny. To be a political person, you don't need a diploma. If for everything you need a master's or a bachelor degree, but you can become a minister without any diploma. So, especially in tourism, that should be applied, I think. Now, let's go quickly, because we have still a few minutes left. A destination brand should be protected by trademark law. When I entered the office of the Dutch Tourism Board, one of my first questions is, who owns the brand Holland? Everybody looked at me and said, brand owned? I said, well, we promote the brand Holland. Do we own it? No. I said, okay, the first thing we do, we're going to own the brand Holland and we make an agreement that we are the owners. Yeah? And I did that, and from that moment, my future was terminated. Because, you know, all the civil servants of the Minister of Economic Affairs were furious at me. What are you doing now? You own the brand? And I said, yes, and now you have to come to me and you have to ask me permission and I give you a franchise, you can use the brand Holland. Yeah, you laugh about it, but for me, my career was nearly finished at that moment. But that you should do. Who owns the brand France? Yeah? Okay. The logo must be recognizable. There are many people who ask me, why do you use this tulip? Can you eat it? Yes, you can, during the war, yeah? But why do you use it? Are tulips the most important thing? Then I say to those people, is the shell of, the symbol of Shell, yeah? Is that what Shell does? No, you recognize the company Shell because of the shell. And the tulip Holland is only because then you recognize Holland. Like Ireland has the four leaves. And so it has nothing to do with tulips or flowers, yeah? Sorry, go too quick. A brand name, easy to translate. We had a problem in Holland. Le Pays-Bas, the Nederlanden, yeah, Netherlands, yeah, so we choose Holland. Everybody knows now Holland is an easy name, yeah, in all languages. Price and quality control of the product. I'm very sure that nearly all of you have been in Venice and have been at San Marco Polo Square and you ordered their cappuccino. That was great, until you got the bill, yeah? 18 euros, yeah, for one cup, something like that. Now, this is funny, so everybody promotes Go to Venice, Italian tourist board, and when you are there, yeah, 18 euro. So, are you coming back? No. So, and then the last line, a consistent long-term policy for branding and product development. That is the most difficult thing. When I was CEO of the Dutch Tourist Board, during 7 years, I had four different ministers of economic affairs. And all four had a complete different strategy in promoting Holland. And I was going from the left to the right. Yeah, and that is something that should be dictated in concrete and for the coming 10 years. Disney is also not changing their strategy, Coca-Cola also not, so why should countries do that? Because then you cannot build up a brand. This is also, in today's marketing, the website is extremely important. Twitter is important, everything, electronical. So the first thing you should do when you do a campaign, you have the URL, claim the URL and make it your ownership. If you look up Big Apple these days, bigapple.com, complete different site. I don't know who's behind it, but it is not an official site. And the same problem we had in Holland as well. The campaign I Amsterdam has been developed because the Amsterdam.com was in the hands of a number of people I don't want to meet tonight. Yeah. So you have to watch it. Yeah. Who owns the URL? Yeah. And what do you do about it? And the same we had with Holland.com, but we got that back, and 25,000 euro, which was a good price. Now, this is brand architecture. If you have the city of Paris, which is in France, how can you combine that? Unilever does this with Unox, and does it with ice creams. Yeah, they all have the Unilever brand in the bottom. They're part of the family. Well, this was the second time in my career that I was nearly finished, because I tried to explain to Amsterdam that the logo Holland did belong under their I Amsterdam. Yeah. Which they said, no, we are Amsterdam. Holland, no. But you're part of Holland. Yeah. So this is what we call brand architecture in destination branding. And I think this should be also a rule. So if you are in Oslo, you see the Norwegian national logo under it, then you know they belong to one family. And this, to whom do you go when you're not satisfied about the service of this hotel? You go to the manager, yeah? But to whom do you go if you find something else? Yeah? Look this up. I have had experience in that, and it is very funny if you say to a tourist board department, guys, this is part of our job. Most of them, they say, we do only promotion. I said, yes, you do promotion, but you do also complaint handling, because that belongs together if you do brand management. I can challenge you, ask tourist board if they have a department that does complaint handling. Very, very few. And this, it's not a fun site. But I tell you, those of you who come from France, yeah, probably your train is not driving back. Can you go to Maison de la France and check there? Yeah. Now, so we promote the destination France or Paris. Now the trains are out of order. Can I look it up at the tourist board site of Paris? That is complaint handling, because you push me to go there. The trains don't go. Yeah. Now, this sound may be exaggerated, but with 9/11, we had Schiphol full with stranded passengers of Americans. It took 2 days before the Dutch government realized we had a problem at our hands, yeah, that these were customers who have been customers in Holland, and they were mad at the Dutch public affairs, because how do they come back? And there was no information. The same is with the cow disease of animals. Yeah. If in Ireland, in the UK, when cities are closed, where can you find the correct information if you want to go on holiday? And see the same if you want to go to Thailand. We should improve this together with tour operators. Yeah. And then I'm nearly finished, and you can have your beer and your cocktails and your wine. This, ladies and gentlemen, is extremely important. You hold the future of our industry in your hands. It is up to you to educate the youngsters that will come and serve our guests. Yeah. And without staff training and hospitality training, we are zil. And I believe that you work for, let's say, the industry of the future. Yeah. A lot of industries are going up to China. So let's the Chinese come here and let's receive them. Let's put them on holiday here. Yeah, let them relax. This is what global economy is all about. Yeah, and so I think in this global economy, it will be great. And I'm absolutely honored that I can speak in front of you, and I wish you a lot of luck in your future career. So let's summarize. In my opinion, if you want to succeed in destination branding or building up a destination brand, try to control the product as much as possible, including the taxi drivers. Yeah, have a consistent promotion all the time. Don't go swap around. Look to your distribution. Look to your URLs. Yeah, how do I do this consequently? Can I do anything of price control? Yeah, personnel. The P from personnel, the training, do it. And then I put down permanent, consistent public-private cooperation. That is where our political people should come in. They should bring them all together, because in our industry, it is the aeroplane, it is the taxi driver, it is the restaurant, it is the hotel, it is the sightseeing that makes the product. They should be combined, and the political people should be more aware that they should have some kind of role in that. And then I want to finish. Seventh is passion. No destination can